Good morning, St. Raphael, and good morning especially to our second graders. This was to be a very special day for you, the day of your first communion. And it's a day that is now kind of sad because you're not able to be here today and to receive the great gift of the Eucharist. And I think about this morning, I started thinking about this passage I'd like to share with you from St. Matthew's Gospel. When Jesus heard of it, he withdrew in a boat to a deserted place by himself. The crowds heard of this and followed him on foot from their towns. When he disembarked and saw the vast crowd, his heart was moved with pity for them, and he cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples approached him and said, "This is a deserted place, for it is already late. Dismiss the crowd so that they can go to the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, "There is no need for them to go away. Give them some food yourselves." But they said to him, "Five loaves and two fish are all we have here." Then he said, "Bring them here to me." And he ordered the crowd to sit down on the grass. Taking the five loaves and the two fish, and looking up to heaven, he said the blessing, broke the loaves, and gave them to the disciples, who in turn gave them to the crowds. They all ate and were satisfied. And they picked up the fragments left over, 12 wicker baskets full. Those who ate were about 5,000 men, not counting women and children. And I think about this message today, because probably of those people who were gathered there, many of them, after Jesus rose from the dead, that they became Christians, and they would have partaken in the Eucharist. And as good as, you know, free food is, because Jesus is giving them free food and they're able to eat free food this day, how much better the Eucharist was for them. And we long for that gift of the Eucharist. We want to receive the gift of the Eucharist. We want to receive the gift of Jesus inside of us. Yes, we do. But that doesn't mean that Jesus doesn't want to feed us today. There may be two different kinds of ways that we could approach this day. The one way, we could be very sad, we could be very upset, we could be depressed, maybe we get a little stubborn and angry at mom or dad or our brothers or sisters or maybe other people who call to talk to us today. Or the other one, and the one that I offer you maybe to think about, is to be looking for how Jesus wants to make this day special for you. Jesus still wants to feed you today. Yes, we would like to receive the gift of the Eucharist. Jesus wants to give you something special today. Will you put on your eyes and start looking around and trying to find, where is Jesus trying to give me that bread that I want, that fish that I want, so that this day that could be so down and so depressing and so sad could be something that's actually very happy. And then when I come forward to receive communion, hopefully in a few weeks or a few months, we'll be able to say, you know what, I remember that first communion day that I was supposed to have, and that was good. But this day, the day I really make my first communion, this day is even better. So let us pray. Lord Jesus, be with our second graders. Be with those who are going to receive their first communion today. Be with them in that special way. Feed their desire for you. Feed them with that desire for that special time that you have prepared for them. May not know it, what that date's going to be right now, Lord, but you are already preparing it. Help them to spend this time continuing to prepare, continuing to long, and continuing to be fed, so that on the special day that they can receive their first communion, it truly is a special day. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.